Hey guys, I'm Toby from GamingPcDealz.com and I've been building cheap budget PCs for a while now, and unlike most people's opinions, you can actually play many new games quite well with them. Now the problem is that with such a small amount of money, you have to be very careful about what components fit together, which are future-proof and can be upgraded easily, and which ones to avoid. And I think that a $400 budget for a gaming PC build is especially tricky to handle because you can do a lot of mistakes you definitely want to avoid. For example, if you're not careful, you can easily build a computer where you are not future-proof, where you basically can't upgrade your PC and you have to buy a completely new one in case you want more performance. Or you waste your money on components which are easily upgradable but lack performance or just don't fit together. Now I think the best way to build a gaming PC with $400 right now is to spend a little less and try to hit the sweet spot between being future-proof and performance while also saving some money for the future. With that approach, you can still build a $400 gaming PC that can play most of the latest PC games with medium to high settings. So if you want to know how to do that, keep on watching because I'm going to share with you how I would exactly build that kind of gaming PC. Now let's start with the components that we can choose most easily. In my opinion, the power supply should be the Power 9 system from Be Quiet. It's a solid and very cheap power supply which definitely has enough power for our gaming PC. It also offers DC-DC multi-rail and even an 80 plus bronze certification, which is pretty good for the price. And as a case, I would buy the Corsair 175R mid-tower gaming case. I think it looks pretty cool and it's very cheap, even though it includes an RGB fan, 6 customizable RGB LEDs, and it has tempered glass, which I'm personally a fan of. It also has plenty of space for additional fans and all our components. Before we come to the more important components, please leave a like, it really means a lot to me and it helps out my channel tremendously. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you want to get more help and information about how to build gaming PCs and how to save more money while doing it. Now, when it comes to the motherboard, the RAM, the processor and the graphics card, I think at this price point, there is no processor plus graphics card combination that beats the Ryzen 3200G. This processor with its integrated Vega 8 graphics unit is just an absolute value for money killer. The processor comes with the newest AMD Zen Plus architecture and an AM4 socket. And it has 4 cores with up to 4.0 GHz. Right now, AMD's Ryzen CPUs are the non plus ultra when it comes to value for money. In games, the Ryzen 3200G is on par with an Intel i7-4770, which costs twice as much. At the same time, the integrated graphics unit is on a similar level as the Nvidia GeForce GTX 745, which costs $95. Additionally, it comes as a boxed version, so you don't need to buy a new cooler because it's already included. So as you can see, you actually get quite a lot for a very small amount of money when you buy the Ryzen 3200G. However, with this cheap processor and graphics combination, we have enough budget left to buy a future-proof motherboard that we can upgrade in the future if we have more budget. Therefore, for the motherboard, I think we should invest in a ASRock B450M Pro 4. It's one of the cheapest motherboards that also support AMD Ryzen CPUs, but it has all the connectors and functions that we need and a high frequency and 4 RAM slots. And because we have 4 RAM slots, we can then buy 2 4GB RAM blocks instead of one single 8GB RAM block, which is better because dual channel is faster in most applications compared to single channel, and we can still upgrade in the future. And for those RAM blocks, I would recommend the RAM from Corsair because it's very cheap and it has a high frequency. In the end, for the flash memory, I would use the very fast PNY CS900 SSD with 240GB. It contains enough space to install the operating system, many games and other applications. Also, I think that SSDs are a must-have these days as they are much faster than the ordinary HDDs while being relatively cheap. So that was it, our $400 budget gaming PC. Again, with this gaming PC you will be able to play most of the latest games with medium to high settings, and at the same time you are prepared very well for the future in case you want to upgrade your build with an even stronger processor and an extra graphics card later. However, I really recommend you to go directly to the $500 gaming PC build video that you can find on the top left, because I think spending about $100 more on your gaming PC is definitely worth it. Because with $500 we can then actually find a really good processor and graphics card combination that actually beats this $400 build by quite a lot. I mean, this $400 gaming PC build is really strong and really good, and it's set up for upgradability on purpose. But I think investing a few more bucks immediately is actually worth it. But for now, let's end this video, and like always, you can find the links to the components in the description under the video. If you liked the video, I'm happy about every thumbs up or subscription. Leave a comment if you have any questions or feedback, and check out the other awesome content on the channel. As always, you guys, thanks so very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.